But all these do-gooders that are out there, and everybody wants to do something good for somebody else, that's wonderful. But I'm a believer that you do as much good as you can at home first. And I wonder if there are enough people out there that they spend their time around the globe. There's a lot that needs to be done right here in New Jersey. People are suffering and struggling and could use help. So, Chris, I wanted to ask you, you were playing some music the other night Yes. on our sister station.
Yep, the last two nights I've been working with a great local New Jersey grassroots effort called Ocean of Love Foundation. And we're working with our sister station. I'm a DJ there at part-time at 105.7 The Hawk.
Okay.
And Ocean of Love Foundation essentially supports families who have children with cancer.
Wow.
And it is one of the greatest grassroots efforts in New Jersey. I support it, and I have learned a lot over the past few years working with them. What they basically do is they help support either financially, moral support, whatever the families need, whatever they're going through. They try to help support, and they have 53 active families right now.
Can I ask you, so 53 families who've got a child suffering with cancer.
Right.
This is not about wearing a ribbon. This is not about feeling good and publicity and awareness. This is about direct contributions to the families to help them meet their bills.
Every cent that we raise goes right to these families.
I mean, I'm so happy to hear that. Now, you were telling me earlier, though, about the cops and the firefighters. Right. They're all involved.
Right. Well, just to back up one second, our afternoon host on the station, Andy Chase, gives up a week of his life to live up on a billboard to raise $105,700. That's the goal.
Wait a minute. All right, hold on. What do you mean he lives on the billboard?
They erect a billboard in the Target shopping center in Toms River, and he lives up there for a week.
All right.
Now, what you're going to ask. If he's got to go, he comes down.
Kira is tight. Yes. I'm looking at that, and of course, that's exactly. Where does he go? Does he have a bucket?
No. Well, sometimes when the weather's really bad, Gatorade bottles do help, I figure out. But
not the other.
Other means he does come down for that, but he's up there for the entire time.
Is there a porta potty right by the base of the billboard?
Yep. And essentially,
have they thought about hoisting the porta potty up to the top?
We were making a joke about because he does have a bucket that goes up and down on a pulley to bring him stuff when he needs it. We thought that would be a good mode to keep him up there, but you know that. Just gross.
Now, is he allowed to have a cell phone? Is he texting?
Yes. He has a laptop up there. He has a cell phone.
So actually, it's kind of a vacation for him. He gets to get out of the hustle and bustle of Jersey life. No commute. It's not bad.
It's not a bad job if you're
not trying to diminish his effort.
No, but he's got a huge heart about it. But last night, I was telling you off air a little bit.
Yeah.
Toms River Fire, EMS, and police came together as you. If you didn't know this was happening down on Hooper Avenue, you would have thought there was a major problem going on in Toms River. They came as a cavalry, lights and sirens blazing. As a unit, came one of the fire trucks from Toms River, hoisted the ladder up to Andy, up on the billboard, and presented him with a check as a collective unit for $9,500.
It's incredible.
It was one of the... To be a part of it last night,
it's huge.
There wasn't a dry eye because our... the president of Ocean Love Foundation, Linda Gillick, she was there and she was on hand last night and we were broadcasting from the ground.
Why is she in charge? Did she have a kid that suffered? Does she have a personal attachment?
Yeah, she had a personal attachment. She started it and it's grown over the years.
God bless her.
Every year there is a story. Wednesday night we had a story of a family, of a former family of Ocean of Love that came and told their story about how Ocean of Love helped them keep their lights on. I mean, paid their power bill because they were so in debt trying to pay for their kids, you know, cancer treatments. They didn't have enough money to even pay for to keep their power on.
I mean, the
things you don't even realize that could happen to these families just because they're trying to get enough money to pay their medical bills for their child. It's heartbreaking.
That's where, I mean, I've said this before, and, you know, I went on a whole discussion yesterday about the pink distraction and people doing things, you know, acting stupid, dumping ice on their head and all the things that people do. You know, if you just turn around and look to the people around you in your neighborhood, there's someone that's suffering that can use some help. And this is the kind of thing that I think more people should get involved with. I realize most people don't have the time, you know, or the schedule that will permit them to do a stunt and be on the billboard But you know what, Andy, you're doing a great thing by doing that. And Chris, I'm glad you brought this to us because that is so real.
Right.
When you talk about a mortgage payment, an electricity bill, you know, the gas bill, the idea of just putting gas in your car so you can continue to go to work. Because what people don't realize is when someone's suffering from an illness like cancer, especially if it's a kid, it's all consuming emotionally. Yep.
Absolutely. I mean, these, you know, the parents that have left their jobs to be by their kids' bedside in the hospitals. I mean, it's just, there's never a dry eye. And the amazing thing I see every year are families that last night we had a family come by that brought their daughter, who was a child of Ocean of Love, is now better and is in remission. And all these families come back, and what are they doing? They're donating.
Now they're giving
to the
back.
Families. Yep. It's an amazing grassroots effort.
All right, Chris, thank you for all your efforts.
Thank you.
It's a great story. We appreciate it. And you can find out more about Oceans of Love on our website, nj1015.com.